We will now discuss how the changing global situation is affecting Antarctica and what are the processes which is happening in Antarctica, which will have a strong implications and how we live in future. Before we understand these changes, we should understand how do Antarctic ice sheet actually exist and how do they behave. This schematic figure shows you the Antarctic ice sheet and its interaction with atmosphere as well as ocean. Antarctica is just like any other continent, have a huge landmass, and the ice which is covered on top of it is formed because of it's so cold and there is atmospheric circulation brings in a lot of moisture there and start depositing, and ultimately you have this piling of snow and an ice sheet. It's accumulated and then redistributed by wind, which forms the Antarctic ice sheet. It has its own behavior. As the ice is getting thick and thick, more than 2 to 3 kilometers, the ice also start flowing from its central line to the sides. And then some of them start floating over the ocean, what we call as ice shelf. And some of them breaks away, makes some icebergs. And around Antarctica also, the formation of sea ice happens because it's so cold during winter. And at the grounding line of where the ice sheet meets ocean, that's place actually where the chances of breakage of most of the ice shelves exist. So in a situation where the globe is warming, the most affected parts are the ice shelves because they're essentially floating over the ocean surface. Antarctica is warming, as I told you, because essentially for a long time, we assumed that Antarctica is immune to the global changes because it's completely separated from the rest of the world because of Southern Ocean and Antarctic circumpolar currents and this polar vortex in the atmosphere and ocean. But analysis of satellite data as well as the available instrument records in Antarctica clearly showed that Antarctica is warming, and it has warmed at a rate of about 0.12 degrees Celsius per decade since 1957. 1957, because that's the time when the first data, instrumental data, started coming from Antarctica. And since 1980s, we have the satellite data, which made the Antarctica much more better understandable. So this figure clearly shows that the West Antarctica is warming much more than the East Antarctica, because East Antarctica is probably in many places still remain very cold. However, this warming is not uniform. You can see that there are patches of this red color around Antarctic Peninsula as well as the Western Antarctica, which is the most vulnerable part of Antarctica. If you want to understand the Antarctica, how it's behaving, you must have heard a lot of late in the newspapers reports. Like last year in July 2017, almost all newspapers carried this particular report. A trillion ton iceberg has detached from Antarctica, which is nearly double the size of the Goa state. And there are several large reports saying actually the iceberg twice the size of Luxembourg breaks off from Antarctic ice shelf. There's a collapse of Antarctic glacier the size of Britain, which threatens to flood the coastal towns. And there are reports which say that scientists warn of the collapse of this particular glacier could be globally catastrophic. The glacier which they're talking is about the Thwaite Glacier as well as the Pine Needle Glacier. We'll discuss more of that later. And even there was a report that nearly 150,000 penguins were almost died because a huge iceberg got detached, and these penguins will end up without any food. So that is the kind of the media reporting it's got in Antarctica and its changing conditions. So that means the people are really worried about it, and therefore we should understand it more scientifically, how it is looking like. First, on the life, the warming effect on the penguin population is one of the dramatic things what you can see. If you look at the graph on the left side, you will see the red curve, which has continuously been decreasing, is about elderly penguins in the Western Antarctica. Their population has been decreasing. Compared to that, the chinstrap as well as the gentoo penguins has been increasing in the recent decades. It has to do with the Antarctic warming or the loss of sea ice, because Adelie penguins live on krills, juvenile krills, which requires the sea ice algae for their life. Because sea ice is decreased in some part, therefore you don't have the algae and therefore you don't have this krills, and thus you have more salps coming into picture. So salps are favored by the gentoo penguins. Therefore, you have the gentoo penguin population is increasing compared to that of the Adelie penguin population is decreasing. So quite a dramatic picture what you see there. If you look at Antarctica on a larger scale, what is ice being lost on Antarctica surface? We have this particular satellite observations, what we call GRACE, Gravity Recovery and Climate Experiment, which use two satellites same time, looking at the gravity variations on the Antarctic surface, which will tell you the minute variations in the ice which is distributed over the Antarctic surface and how it is behaving through time. Ever since that satellite has been into the on space, what we see, since 2002 to 2017, there's a continuous decrease of mass of Antarctic ice, which is almost 125 gigatons per year. However, remember that again, this loss is not uniform throughout the Antarctica, dominantly over the West Antarctica, and that too around two major glaciers like Pine Island Glacier and Thwaite Glacier, which is one of the dramatic variations what we can see it. That's where the going to be the major variations happening in the near future. The entire Antarctic Peninsula and Western Antarctica is under threat. If you look at more detail, the effect of warming on Antarctica, it's not just about the ice shelves being lost because of the warming which is happening, atmospheric warming which is happening. Large areas on Antarctic ice shelves are also affected by the basal melt. Basal melt is nothing but the melting of ice shelves from beneath because of the seawater, because seawater is warming and therefore the ice is being eaten away from the bottom, and then because of solar radiation it's also melting from the surface. So it's double whammy, and the rate of basal melt of Antarctic ice shelves when you overlay it off the Antarctic mosaic, what we see is actually there is a large areas like in West Antarctica and the Antarctic Peninsula have a red color, which has a strong basal melt, as well as those pie diagrams which says how much is being calving and how much is being basal melt has been happening. You can see the large areas are because of the basal melt. So this is something which was not understood till then. Now it is not only just atmospheric warming, but it's also because of the water which is touching these ice shelves, the floating bodies of ice are affecting their health. One example is here, the Pine Island and Thwaite Glacier, which I was just mentioning earlier, the two spots on the right side of the figure, where you can see that it's not only just a glacier, but also the entire ice sheet on the West Antarctic ice sheets are actually feeding to it, which is open to the sea. So therefore, there is a circulation going behind these ice shelves, leading to melting of this from bottom. And then there is a calving of this ice front. As a result, this West Antarctic ice sheet is particularly vulnerable to ocean warming induced collapse. And the total discharge from the Thwaites Glacier and the Pine Island Glacier from this region has been increased by nearly 77% since 1973. And most of the spill took place in the recent decades. So that you can imagine what's going to happen as we increase the global temperature again by another 0.5 degree. More importantly, if this glaciers melt completely, it could raise the global sea level by 1 meter. So it's a serious implications. So the vulnerability of ice shelves are quite now very well known. In fact, we have been seeing loss of many ice shelves, like you lost Larsen A ice shelf in 1995, Larsen B ice shelf in 2002, and the remaining one is Larsen C ice shelf on the Antarctic Peninsula. We saw that last July, in 2017 July, the large chunk of big iceberg formed out of it, what we call actually the trillion ton iceberg. However, you can see that there is a two pink spots on it. this particular glacier, you can see that, so particular ice shelf, which are what we call it ice rise. Ice rise are the place where the ice is grounded. That means there is touching the land. Therefore, it provides the pinning support, its support to the ice shelf, become more stable. Because of these ice rises, people believe that the Larsen C ice shelf is more stable. Anytime these ice rises become unstable, it could be more disaster to that particular ice shelf. So what we found last year, there's a large iceberg when it break away. It just started from just close to the Gibbs ice rise and then ended at somewhere close to the Bowden ice rise. So these two ice rises form the boundaries from between which actually this you lost one huge iceberg. And the stability of this Larsen C ice shelf is basically depending on these ice rises. This is one model study which suggests the critical role of ice rises on the stability of ice shelves, Antarctic ice shelves. It shows that these two ice rises, the Gibbs ice rise and Bowden ice rise, are the critical pinning points that stabilize the ice front. And if these ice rises are weakened, the flow speeds could substantially increase and could potentially destabilize the Larsen C ice shelf. This is a modeling study, and in fact, the last year loss of this particular huge iceberg clearly supported this one. So what is the role of ice rises on the stability of ice shelves? As I told you, the ice rises are basically the places where you have this pinning bodies, where the ice rise touches the ice shelf. There's a small mound forms. That's what we call actually the ice rise. And these ice rises have a significant role how stable your ice shelf could be. The ice rises behave as like a cork of a bottle, where although we are never interested in a cork, we are only interested in the liquid inside that. But cork is so important because the moment the cork is opened or the lost, the fizzy water inside could be lost from the bottle. Therefore, we say that the ice rise has a significant impact on the health of these ice shelves, and in turn, the health of the Antarctic ice sheet, because ice shelves are the one which buttress or support the ice sheet coming flowing into the ocean. And ice rise are the one which helps the ice shelves to be stabilized. If you lose ice rise, you are going to lose ice shelves, and which in turn will loosen up large amount of ice from the ice sheet. So it has a very critical role. So therefore, we need to study about Antarctic ice shelves, as well as the role of ice rises on these ice shelves. This picture again tells you that actually the flowing of Antarctic ice along the various ice shelves. The red color shows that faster speed. The next figure shows you that large number of ice rises and ice rises existing all along the ice shelf, which is making these ice shelves very stable. And wherever there is no ice rise, there could be more, instability existing. When we come back, we will try to understand what India is doing in Antarctica, what kind of studies we do it to understand this climate variability and its impact on Antarctica.